Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how I make a French hood and in addition how I make some Tudor accessories. So you're probably asking yourself, what the heck is a French hood? Well, if you can tell from the image on the screen, it is one of two types of headgear that Tudor ladies at the court wore. The other one was the gable hood. I'll put a picture of it on screen. Now, what is the difference between the French hood and the gable hood? The gable hood is a lot more conservative. It covered the entirety of the hair. Whereas if you can see from the picture, the French hood, which was a little bit scandalous at the time, actually showed the front of your hair. Its purpose was to cover the back, and it was considered still a head covering. So yeah, here we go. Okay, so here you can sort of see the pieces that we're going to need. This bottom piece is called the crescent, and the top piece is called the paste. So right now they're drawn in sort of reverse order. The paste is going to be what goes around the head with those short little sides covering your ears, and the crescent is what makes that distinctive French hood shape. Now comes the not so fun part, the long and arduous process of sewing wire onto your pieces. So hopefully you can see what I'm doing here. I'm sorry if it's a bit out of frame. My desk is just really tiny. Basically, what you're gonna do is you're sewing wire onto each of the pieces so that when you bend it, it stays in the shape of your head. If you can, please do yourself a favor and do this with a sewing machine. My machine is like 15 years old, so there's no way it would handle a piece of wire. And frankly, the thumb pad of my right thumb is really paying for it right now. So yeah, if you can use a sewing machine, and if you have to do it by hand, I would recommend wrap your thumb or something, or whatever finger you're going to use, wrap it in fabric, just protect it. Do yourself a favor. So now that your pieces are wired up, now comes the time to cover them in a layer of linen, and then in a layer of your top fabric, and then you sew them together, put on the jewels, and you fit it to your head. So let's get back to sewing. So here's what I mean when I say covered in fabric. So as you can see, the paste is covered in linen and then in silk damask. So that way,
You can't see any of the wire.
And now, after all this work, we can finally get to the fun part, sewing on the decorations. So for this, I'm going for a pretty traditional decoration for a French hood, which is a row of pearls. Usually you would have two rows of pearls, but I felt that one row was just a lot more elegant, so that's what I did. So, quick little update. We've finished the French part of the French hood, with the exception of cutting off a couple of these damasks. Now comes the hood part of the French hood. We need a veil. So the veil was traditionally made out of black velvet, so that's what I'm going to do as well. This is made out of a buckram paste. It's a buckram facing with wire, and then I put linen. And I put the silver damask on top, and here you can see a filament of pearls. Let's get back to it! This is my fifth time attempting to film this. Hopefully it works out. Anyway, here's the hood. As you can see, the hood part is made out of black velvet, as was typical. And the French part of the French hood is silver damask with gold in it. And it's got a filament of pearls. So, if I were a Tudor lady, I would be a very rich Tudor lady because this has gold in it. And back then, the gold would be metal threads that were gilded in gold, so extremely expensive. So yeah, I think I'm ready to hit up the Ren Faire in style.